your grandma ever say to you that if it is itching, it is healing? Putting a bandage over an open wound helps it heal by preventing dirt and other particles from hurting the wound even more. It is a fact that leaving your wounds alone helps the healing process, and many people also say that healing improves when we remove the bandages after some time. However, the healing process can cause a lot of itching. The itch can end up irritating even more a skin that is already sensitive, and sometimes the growing tissues might be removed when we accidentally scratch the itching scabs, which ends up slowing the recovery and causes a scar. But do you know why your healing wounds itch? The skin has specialized nervous fibers that detect when our dermis is irritated, and those fibers send a signal to the spinal cord to let us know that there is an itch. These nerves can be triggered in many different ways. For example, if a bug crawls over your skin, these fibers focus on the area and send a sign to let the spinal cord know of potential danger. According to the University of Cambridge, this is called mechanical stress. The healing of a wound can also trigger mechanical stress, which will activate the itching response. As it heals, the cells around the wound start to proliferate, which means that the edges of the wound grow and start moving inside towards its base. These cells then unite in the center and start contracting to close the wound. This process triggers the mechanical stress that activates the itching nerves and makes you want to scratch that area. Isn't it interesting? All of that happens because the body releases histamine in response to the wound and its sudden exposure to external elements. Other factors can also increase itchiness. Still, according to the researchers, during the recovery process, the healing tissues can overgrow and cause a keloid, which in turn irritates even more the area. Although they are usually harmless, keloids can cause skin discoloration after the healing, which prolongs the time necessary to improve the scar. That's why it is important to wait for the internal healing of the tissues so the wound doesn't open again. If a person is not correctly oriented, their wounds can open again or increase in size since it doesn't have collagen yet, and the scabs itch because the skin gets dry. If that's your case, learn some cautions you must take during the healing process and with your scars. It is necessary to be careful with the exposure of your wound so it doesn't rupture. Remember to not scratch the scars in their initial phase. Did you know that rubbing your hand over the healing area increases the sensation of itchiness? So keep your nails always clean and well trimmed. Do not expose the healing area to sunlight while the scar hasn't reached a color close to your skin tone. And use sunscreen to protect the scar, since the area will be more sensitive. And last but not least, if the itching becomes too intense, seek a doctor or dermatologist who will prescribe you an antihistamine or low-potency corticoid. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more recipes and tips, subscribe to the channel.